Organizational best practices. Introduction. Outside of file structure and naming, organization is also important to other aspects of your Unreal Engine project, such as level structure and in the sequencer. As well as keeping things organized, proper structure also allows larger groups of team members to collaborate through being able to check out subsections of the content so they can work on different pieces at the same time. This is important for levels and sequences because they are binary files and cannot be merged. Level structure. Level structure should be assembled as a series of sublevels beneath an empty persistent level. Sublevels should be roughly broken down by discipline and type of asset contained to allow multiple artists to work in parallel. Let's take a look at an example level structure. The blockout sublevels contain blockout shapes from the initial rough design of the set. Keeping these sublevels are important as a reference later when final assets are added. This is separated into a main blockout level and a hidden level. As artists import final assets, they can position the assets according to the blockout, and then move the old blockout version of the asset to the hidden level. This way, an up-to-date version of the scene can always be visualized with a mix of blockout and final assets. Once final assets are all imported, all blockout elements should be on the hidden level. The cameras, characters, landscape, and VFX sublevels are fairly straightforward, containing respective elements matching the names. The light scenario sublevels contain different lighting looks for the scene, such as different times of the day or weather conditions. These can be toggled on or off to match the intended look of the scene for particular shots. The light sublevels contain other scene lights that operate independently of the specific lighting scenarios. The set dressing sublevel contains the final assets for set dressing that are dropped in over the blockout. This can be split into multiple different sublevels depending on the size of the scene or the number of artists working concurrently. Sequencer structure. Unreal Engine sequences viewed in the sequencer panel can be structured in different ways depending on the type of project you are working on. An in-camera VFX project might use this to control some background animations in order to provide precise timing for shots, but generally won't require an overly complex structure. In this case, the sequencer can be divided into a master sequence and sequences for each of the animations. Animated productions, on the other hand, feature many different sequences, shots, and animations stacked at the same time, and benefit from a much more granular division of subsequences in order to allow collaboration and keep things organized. In this case, it's better to have separate sequences for different disciplines, similar to the level breakdown, such as camera, animation, lighting, VFX, etc. Level sequences are given the prefix LS, with sublevel sequences using SLS. The suffix denotes the type, such as underscore light or underscore VFX. Creating and importing assets. Creating assets in Unreal, such as primitive shapes, is usually done for blockout purposes. As such, these should be placed in the correct blockouts folder. Unreal Engine does not do this automatically, but you may change your preferences in the asset picker to allow this by navigating to the correct folder, then going to the Modeling tab and selecting the option for Current Folder. Afterwards, assets can be renamed as desired without also having to change folders. As touched on before, the generally recommended way to handle imported assets is by keeping them in the original folder structure with original naming, but contain them all in a designated folder for this purpose. In the structure we shared earlier, this will be assets/packs. If these files need to be edited, this can be done by duplicating the original and adjusting the variant identifier to match the purpose for which it is being duplicated.